NS-15, hostile forces are attacking the outpost. Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians. Advent came in hot and so did we. You won't have a concealed position for deployment on this one.
Hey folks, how you all doing? This is Con Ulrich coming to you with another episode of XCOM 2 Rangers and Rookies. I will notice it's kind of funny for me to have Bradford make the comment that,
Roger that.
ET doesn't have a, what you call it? Oh, geez, wow. Concealed position, and neither do we, because every single one of my Rangers has concealment. But that's just me. I just like the idea. That's like, hey, cool. You think you know what you're talking about, but you don't, son. We are special.
Moving out.
That being said, we are up to a point now. Phew, actually, I just thought to myself for a second, what if he's a faceless? We are up to a point right now where we are still haven't quite gotten to that black site mission just yet, which is okay because our guys are still a little bit underleveled. But at the same time, we are in a decent shape. We actually have a full squad of Rangers, as long as we don't lose anybody stupidly, which is definitely a skill of mine. We should be okay. Actually, now that I think about it too, we are actually through the first level of tech upgrades, so now actually we have shard guns as opposed to shotguns, which I am also totally okay with. You jerkwad. Alright, I guess you know who the first guy to die will be. Sorry, Zalid Kabadabi.
We're seeing heavy civilian casualties, Commander. We have to stop this.
And the thought occurred to me that I have a couple unifying factors going on with my squad right now. One of them is having everyone with bandanas. So colloquially, I would call them to be the Bandana Brigade. But at the same time, I think there are some other things we need to get clear. Like Thomas Harris, once he gets a nickname, he will be the son of Slanish. Anybody out there who knows 40K will tell you that Slanish is definitely a guy all about riotous colors and crazy hairstyles and things like that. And that's totally going to be Thomas Harris. Oh, dude, it's like a mini squad. As it is, Thomas actually also has venom rounds in his shotgun. He also has, if I remember correctly, a acid grenade. So in my mind, I'm definitely going up for that entire kind of like shtick. And to me, it makes sense. Well, if it makes sense to anybody else, I'm not so sure, but that's neither here nor there, I suppose. Also, since we have another civvy that's right there, my guess is it's going to take a shot at that civvy, and I'm okay with that, because it allows my guys to get in position and reveal themselves one at a time. Even more perfect. Well, except for the guy who's going to die right now. I'm sorry, Alessandro. So yes, no, this is the first episode after the successful completion of our first campaign together. That being said, of course, we are now in an Ironman campaign with our Rookies and Rangers squad. And why do I see such a massive thing over there? I don't know, but let us take this lovely 99% shot with a 55% crit. Let's see if we can do it once and done, and ka-chow. And I bet some of you are wondering, why am I not putting anybody on Overwatch? Well, because Overwatch is going to do a darn bit of difference with Phantom. As long as everybody else is concealed, why the heck is he going to do anything like, you know, remotely connected to his survivability? Which works for me, I'm totally okay with that. And to prove that I'm okay with that, Isabella is going to drop up right next to you from where Irina was and just kind of say, ka-chow. And she's revealed now too. Oh, isn't that a shame?
There you go.
Oh, come on, sound a little more happy, come on, jeez. Okay, that's one thing I don't agree with this game, is the idea that they have eyes on me. Think about it, I just killed everyone right here. No one's got eyes on me.
Got it.
And Eves, this is probably not the smartest to move everyone that far. Okay, cool, we're okay. I'm sensing grenades in my future. I'm also sensing at least one more dead civvy, because I am not going to be able to get over there in time. Even though I might want to. And I definitely do want to. I'm also thinking about, since I have the Son of Slanish over here with Thomas Harris, Halima is now all in red, or I prefer to call it crimson armor. And although she definitely has a whole little kind of like shtick going on, I'm definitely thinking that she is going to be... Oh no.
I'd go out like this.
I did. Just raising my hand personally, but I, you know... Unarmed civilian ducking out in the middle of the open. It's like he's playing hide and seek and screaming, I'm right here!
Commander.
Please, find me!
We need to get these people out of here.
But I think I turn most of my squad into kind of like a quasi-chaos squad. You know, so getting up all of the nifty different helmets and things like that. I'm totally okay with doing that. I'm actually kind of ready for it. With that being said, let's shift Thomas forward. Get eyes on. You guys, I can't get too much more for it because you'll be seen. But you, my friend, can go right here and pick up two. And that's what you shall do.
Seems doable.
It is doable, my friend. Now do it.
Come on, hustle!
Run. Oh, son of a pearl. And he's gonna park that other squad too, isn't he? Yep. Oh, isn't that just kind of an unfortunate move? You know, you try to be nice and save people, and then they just don't want to be saved. They just turn out to be faceless monsters, and they're gonna kill you. That's just not what you want to see sometimes.
I'm on it.
That's okay. That's okay, we'll pull his fat out of the fire, and all will be well. That will not be well, but this will all be well. Especially if y'all keep shooting like that, we'll be all set, son.
Is it clear?
Actually, after this turn, might be Slanish might be the only dude that's actually still in cover. 64, just in case, because I have... There we go, cool. Because we're going to have Athena still have to move.
Okay, so I got one.
But with this bro right here, I'm kind of a little bit nervous about leaving our good friend out in the open. And of course you can't quite see things, so that's okay. Maybe we should just shift up right here. And it's only a moderate difficulty too, so there can't be that many more guys on this map. So there's one there, two, there's a couple more guys up there too, so let's toss you into cover right behind here.
I can handle that.
And pray to the great god Mata that the Viper won't steal people out of cover. Oh, there's a Muton over here too. Please miss. Or not. So in the middle of her death cry, she wonders how she went out like this. That's cool. Just bind me, please. Okay, I'll take the bind. That's fine. Because at least being bound means he won't get shot. This might be a little unlucky, though. Yeah, it's a little unlucky. It's fine. We'll make it work. And here comes a grenade. Screaming for a grenade, in fact. That's considered to be a flank. Oh, yeah, dude, he's right in the open. That's why. Duh. Okay, so I imagine if I go right here, I have a better cover, which is what I need to do right now. And I go ka-chow, and hopefully you kill. Good shooting, my dear. Good shooting.
Hostile target down.
So Eve's no longer bound, which is good. In fact, he might have grenade, too. So if they throw a frag grenade and roll high... That's not what you want to do. Like, you don't want to roll high. You don't want the game to help you roll better. You want to do the death, don't you? You want to do the dance. So this might come to me actually having to use one of these things. It will, in fact. So Advent Trooper. Death. And he trips and falls over the faceless monster right behind him.
Well, how about that?
Hold on, my dear. Hold on.
Compromised.
Not really compromised, it's more like it never was great to begin with. But hey, enough about my dating life. How good is your 73%? I don't really want to use you. I'd really like to be able to hit this guy from range, but I'm not sure it's going to happen. 44, yeah, that's not going to happen. You're going to reload.
Ready to engage.
You, my son. Have a lousy hit to hit, but you have the acid grenade, the gas grenade rather. So the poison. But you're still hidden. So you know what? How about you go right here?
No problem, boss.
You might proc the Muton, which is a unfortunate thing I'm willing to do. Oh, you didn't. How about that? And Eve says, not in my house.
Not too shabby.
There's still one more dude out here. Now where that guy is, we're not entirely sure. Like, where in the world is the Muton San Diego? And if you did not watch that show as a kid, do not come crying at me if you don't know what I'm talking about. Because that show was just, that was life. That show was life. It was amazing. You learned so much. It was an awesome song. It was great times. Hey, wow, it's an entire squad.
These mutons seem a little more agile than the ones we fought in the past.
Giant frogs.
It looks like they're still serving.
No, don't run away.
The aliens front line, though.
I don't want you to run away. You are my friends, and I would like to kill you. I mean.
Heading out.
Okay, that's a nice safe move. There should work. This should work as well.
Let's do this.
All right, I need to rescue four, so I can successfully let three more die if necessary. I mean, that's ideal. In fact, that's kind of like the antithesis. There's the word I'm looking for. It's the antithesis of good stuff happening. But whatever. And whoever bought a Prius, and you know, when the world was ending, that's their own stupid fault. Shotguns have a repeater on it. Yeah, it's a repeater. Cool. It's been a while since I've actually played through XCOM 2. I took a quick break for a few days. Kind of regenerating, see what the next thing I'm going to be doing is. Actually, I think, by the way, one of the things I'm going to be focusing on is the new game coming out for Masters of Orion. Now, Masters of Orion is definitely kind of like your Civilizations type game. And frankly, in my mind, it's actually been done really, really well. Does anyone have a move left after this? You do. Even me, the babe with the power. You know what? You're going to slide into cover here instead. You're going to overwatch just in case. Okay, that's fine. You can proc the dude from there. However, you can't miss him. That's kind of actually a no-no. And since there's two stun lancers, one of my guys is going to get seen.
Missed.
Namely, the one that's still in cover. And concealed. Apparently, it wasn't working very well. Like, oopsies. Yep, and there it is. Okay, first things first.
I'm on it.
Shift you right about here. Hopefully, you should get eyes on. Since he has a death wish, let's take a speculative shot from here. Oopsies. Is he out in the open now? He's out in the open. Okay, well, I get to the cover at least.
That is not good.
That's okay. I mean, it's not perfect, but it's not terrible. They're definitely more terribly awful bad things you've done before. And that's not a positive thing, to have done more terrible bad awful things than you have before. Okay, Blitz, you actually might be in a very interesting position. Okay, we're gonna try this. I'm gonna toss a frag grenade. Okay, that was gonna do more than it did. It's not gonna do exactly what I was hoping for. However, we do this, we take out hopefully that tree, that guy's cover, do some damage, and get rid of the actual cover over there, the left-hand side guy, too. So, yowza, we're doing okay. We're doing okay. We're not doing great, but we're doing okay. Alright, you're still flanked, which is a teensy bit different problem. And he somehow still has cover, which is also a problem, but that's a different kind of problem altogether. Okay, you're in half cover, technically. But if you move up to this cover right here, and that rock wall would have been even better, and I realized after the fact that was perfect cover, you're gonna take this dude out. Okay, you were supposed to take that dude out. And the fact that you didn't is very disappointing to me. You're gonna shift up and you're gonna take that dude out now.
Over there.
A giant waste of grenades and everything. Only a 74? Oh, good god. You disappoint me. Almost as badly as Master Yoda did at the end of episode 2. You are going to take a ton of fire, aren't you, my dear? And you can't safely bolt with a lot of places. So, Tomas, you're going to go right back here to awesome cover and hope that's going to be enough for you. 100%. Perish the thoughts. Okay, he better not just ducked. Oh, wow. Dude, that was like a little dancing move there. Okay, so we're going to get stun-locked by somebody, which is going to be kind of annoying. Even more annoying is the fact that now she is flanking someone, isn't he? Oh, no. Okay, that's fine. You can wreck that person all you want to. I mean, that's not ideal, but that's okay. Look, I killed him. Be mean, be green, be pink. And here comes the charge. He's going to get the Son of Slanish over here. Whoa, what? Okay, that was a curious decision.
Hostiles coming in from the sides.
It's a very curious decision. Okay. I can live with that, I suppose. So you're right here, so you have absolutely no excuse to not hit. He's flanked and everything. I'm like, actually, you know what? Isabella, you're going to take a shot, because if you don't shoot him and kill him, I'm going to be very upset. How do you people not kill them? They're like right there. They're asking to be shot. It's like, please shoot me right now. I'm pretty sure the aliens aren't thinking to themselves, hey, maybe we can take them out just enough. They'll be damaged. That way, the next time we have an actual mission, they won't be here for it. That's a crit. That's how you should be shooting.
Target eliminated.
God. Some people just have no respect for how things are supposed to go. I shoot you, you fall down. That's how it should go. And if it doesn't go that way, now whose fault is that? It's yours, not mine. Okay, gas grenade. Mando gas. Somehow that shreds with the poison. Okay, I wonder if I can get close enough with a grenade. Should be able to, I think, from this distance. You're damaged a little bit, which is kind of annoying. But the grenade should come through. You had it. I saw it. I knew it. It exists. You know what? That's fine. Let's try this grenade. Maybe we can get rid of the tree trunk. It did not do anything like that. Of course. Of course. I trust you to do something intelligent, like get rid of the thing. But no. You're like, hey, I think I don't want to do it. Which is exactly what I did not want you to do. I don't want to group up because he'll throw a grenade. I can do a Death of Glory charge. 84%? No, because he'll do the whole, like, counter thing, and that's not going to be fun either. So, not quite a Death of Glory charge, but you know what? Let's shift right about here. And at this range, 87%, we really should be able to hit him. So, there we go. Well done, lads. Well done. I clap you on the back. And I salute you.
Weapons burning ammo fast.
Oh look, last person on the map. It's a faceless. Okay, I can deal with that. As moderates go, it's kind of annoying. We got three or four guys wounded, but that's what's going to happen with a resistance hit, I guess. Do we get slightly better gear? That the putty attacks me. They're behind me! They're shifting their attack! Alright, so first things first, who can get eyes on that ugly? You can. And you will. And you're gonna play tag with bullets. Okay, that was much less nice than I thought it would be. Who gets the kill? See, Fatal's already got a promotion. Arena, on the other hand, she's gonna say, you know what? I don't believe in your god. Where's your god now? Oh, wow. And he says, right here, apparently.
I'll get him next time.
She's like, wow, what big teeth you've got. Huh. How about that? That's a little bit annoying.
On my way.
Very annoying, in fact. Eh, sorry about that, folks. Where were we? Oh, wow. Okay. Excuse me. We were clearing our throat. That's where we were. All right. So, checking real quick. Oh, 94%. That's why it was going to work. Meanwhile, Isabella says, fine. Your god has blessed you once, but does lightning strike twice? And it is clear that it does not. And ladies and gentlemen, that's the end of Operation Shattered Vengeance, which is always good for me, because I always dread Haven hits with just one class of individual.
Menace 1-5, status confirmed. We're not picking up any additional contacts. The AO is clear. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Cool. So I got a promotion there. So 3 wounded, not too bad. 10 up, 10 down. Pretty quick. We rescued most of the civilians, the bulk of them, in fact. So I'm actually okay with it. So yeah, we'll see you guys back at base. Just check in a minute. Alright, so guys, welcome to the aftermath of Operation Shattered Vengeance. Somehow, apparently taking 3 wounds is the difference between getting gravely wounded, wounded, or lightly wounded. Not ideal, but whatever. So Isabella is now running Gunner Conceal. I'll have to check to see who's got what on that one. Hey, Corporal Harris has Shadow Strike or Shadow Step. You know, getting the whole kind of, like, chaos thing going on, I kind of think Shadow Strike, but Shadow Step is just too good, dude. Or Reaction Fire. It's too good. I have to do it. I have to do Shadow Step. And it's not letting me pick it. Why are you not letting me pick this? I don't know, we'll figure this out in a second, I guess. So, what do we get? 1 Advent Corpse, a couple other corpses. Yeah, but big deal. Cool. Yes. Here's an autopsy.
Hello, Commander.
Oh, yeah, so I got this whole income increase. Yay. There we go. Go here. Gonna promote people. And here's again. 13 days, 3 days. It's a little ridiculous to me. Let me pick this now. This is very strange. This will not let me pick. Hold on, folks. I'll be right back. Okay, so we managed to get one person get a promotion. There we go. That's one. Razor. Now, first of all, again, let's change this right now, because I'm not doing this. Nickname, Son of Slanesh. Aw, dude, not cool. You know what? We're just gonna give him the actual gods' names. It's a little bit heretical, but I think, you know what? If you know the gods, it makes sense. So we'll go from there. There we go, Slanesh. Now it's Thomas Slanesh Harris. Loving it. Definitely looks like it. Maybe I'll give him the Kabuki painting. Who knows? Shadow Step, Shadow Strike. Shadow Step it is, because I think it's just too OP. And yeah, so here we are, back in the mess that this is. Let's toss in one of our healing rate Joes. So now our people get double the speed, which is good, because I need to get them back before a week. Kind of bad to just continue the way they are. One day, I'll get the whole Advent skulljacking thing, I think, pretty soon. I'll totally get to the amusement center in a second, because that sounds awesome. Avengers, let's jump you back over here real quick. Course. And pick this bad boy up. And of course, I forgot about the cinematic.
This was easier than your last procedure, Doctor.
Central, Commander. Yes, I find the process Tigen. To be far less disconcerting when the subject has already expired. The results, however, it's best you see for yourself. My autopsy of the Advent Captain has confirmed the existence of an implant, similar in design to the unit I extracted from the Commander. But there are differences.
Naturally.
What kind of differences?
The data you see is being pulled directly from this Advent Captain's implant. The sequence here is essentially you, Commander. Or at least the tactical information they were processing through your mind.
As you can see, the data is nearly identical. They were using you against us.
Yes, however, the Advent data shows signs of decay. Removing the Commander from their network has likely caused significant damage.
Network?
Yes, what we're seeing here is a psionic network. These implants are capable of receiving and transmitting information, a great deal of information. Somehow encoded in a stream of psionic energy. My working theory? Advent uses this network to augment the tactical readiness of its troops, as well as disseminate orders from its central command. Observe. Even in the subject's diminished condition, the implant continues to have an effect. A truly astonishing achievement.
Or a weakness.
Potentially. But I need direct access to their network to know for sure.
I'm guessing that won't be easy.
We'd need an active link. And that would mean hacking a live Advent officer.
Like I said, not easy. Still,
It's the best lead we've got. Your call, Commander.
Coward.
New objective added.
We're ready to move when you are, Commander.
Okay, so we got all this stuff over here, so what to pick up instead? Gauss weapons would be insane.
The Advent Captain seems to provide a means of stabilizing the link between the local subordinates and the Advent Network Tower itself.
Commander, if we're going to try to...
Let's do this. Skip. All right, cool. So the Advent Lancer things can be picked up. At that point, we will have all of our lovely fusion blades, the stun blade thing, which is good, because we need that, frankly. Cool. Recover from wounds. Also recovered from wounds. Fantastic.
Commander, to aid in ignore. Efforts, we have gathered
so firefight to get a soldier? No. Waste of time. Reducing cost? Good idea. Let's do that. Then what we might try to do is try to pick up that, at least the contact at the Advent site. Because I don't think I've made contact yet. That's right. Okay, and this will be a little annoying, but at the same time it's workable. We can deal with that.
These findings will likely prove crucial to our ongoing.
So we got this, the Arc Blade, definitely cool.
Advent clearly intended for these units to be their means of dealing with any unruly civilians within the city centers.
Skip.
Knowing that despite a thorough analysis,
battle scanner, nice, all kind of good stuff. New research, what can we do?
Hybrid soldiers,
weapons and robotic systems, that's gremlins. That'll be good. That might be better to the intel. Don't have to worry about psionics. Let's do the data pad.
I had assumed you
and
priority,
we still have the proving ground.
Notify you as soon as the report is available.
So it's time to build the proving ground, which means you can hopefully...
Maximum
oh, no, we need power.
Consumption reached.
Given all she's got, Captain. Alright, how many people are still left in here? One. And she's there for like another day or two, I think. 2 days. And that's done in 4. So hopefully we can get through everything. Which should be sweet.
Incoming message for you, Commander.
What we gotta do? Oh, never mind. Cool, we got this. Nice.
Now. You have made considerable progress against the aliens over the past month, Commander.
Cool.
I hope that your ongoing efforts...
Alright, so Viper rounds, Rapid Response, or New Construction? Oh, whatever. You're gonna have that. I think I'll probably do that one. Negate the whole Rapid Response. We'll check that out in a little bit. Okay, she's back up from wounds, which is great. And next region cost is done by 50%. Also pretty darn good. In the meantime, let us drop our person back out, because that's one day there. I'll toss someone in here to actually begin excavating.
Commander, I'm going to need more help on the engineering team before I can start clearing out some of these other rooms. We should recruit an engineer.
Okay, so 30 days there, one day there. We have anyone else left in there, power capacity, so when that comes down, we'll build a power center there. Coolio and all that.
Commander, we've got local resistance forces waiting to make contact, but we'll have to make the first move.
Fire and ready, I forget this does. Oh, it's completed instantly. Awesome. Let's do this, though. Let's make contact and be like, oh yeah, exactly. Absolutely nothing. Which is why I guess that
Commander,
whole...
we've utilized all of our available communications
capacity.
Probably
missed
we
that a little bit. Oh well.
New contacts until we upgrade our systems.
We'll make it work. We'll get to that in a second, too. Okay, so view the room. Got a bunch of Illyrium crystals.
Commander, we've pushed our current power systems to the limit. We don't have any capacity.
No, that's not what I meant to do. That's not what I meant to do.
We can't expand our facilities further.
No. I don't want this. I had the wrong thing. Delete. Cancel. There we go. Let's try this again.
Maximum power consumption reached.
Power relay.
Power relay construction initiated.
There we go. Much better.
Maximum power consumption reached.
Interesting. I could build a proving ground on top of the power relay, but I couldn't build any. I can't do it now. It's a little strange. Oh well. Assign an engineer, my friend.
As far as I can tell, advanced technology, along with most of what we've seen going on in the city centers, is based on variations, and in some cases,
not what I meant. There we go.
Used during the invasion. Luckily, the more common the stuff becomes, the easier it'll be for us to find components that can work.
Alrighty. So we got all that stuff coming on. We got that whole thing coming out. We have used up all of our contact stuff right now. Intel, lovely.
As intriguing as I do, Commander.
Let's see what to do next. Mutant autopsy. Let's do that.
Central officer.
Jump. Alrighty. Some midnight raids and vigilance. So it'll be harder to catch them off guard, and it's gonna have more cost for Intel, as I recall. Let's make contact, get some more supplies in. Skip that too, just a little bit quicker, you know.
Commander, we've established contact with the local resistance. And
hooray!
Move on the alien black side on your
own. All right, so I built something there, or I may build. Let's pick this thing up first. Then we'll build what you call it, a relay right about there.
I've updated our current objectives based on the most recent findings. Commander, the aliens have made significant progress toward their goals.
Or we'll have to go to the left. Who knows?
Cropping up around the world.
We gotta go after that project, so don't we? Yep, we do. Oh well.
Commander, the aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar project. If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
Arg, okay.
Commander, with the number of contacts,
so scientists, okay.
Request for support from multiple sites around the world.
Unfortunately,
we only have the resources to respond to one of them.
The one that's going to be easy for us, the one I actually want to get rid of, is, you know, a scientist, and I'm not really going to need to worry about scientists since we're so much further along. So do I have to put up with reinforcements, maybe? Maybe I'll have to put up with reinforcements and just pick up another engineer instead. Yeah, I think we'll do that, I guess. I said I was going to go to the east, but I guess I'll just pick up the engineer. Cryptic Anger. So, I guess this delays the next facility being constructed, at least. But for the meantime, guys, thanks so much. I appreciate you guys checking out the channel. Thank you guys for giving me so much time and all your patience and attention. And when we come back, we'll handle Operation Cryptic Anger, and maybe I'll take one of these other guys and turn him into a Nurgleite or something like that. I don't know. If you guys have any ideas of how you want me to run this particular squad, let me know. We'll be happy to see what you got. And I'll see you guys all next time on XCOM 2 Rookies and Rangers. This is Connell Work signing off. Take it.